It's the 3rd of March
2024.
I'm at the South Mimms services on the M25 and I'm here just to look at the electric vehicle charging because this is another one of those motorway services which has seen huge expansion recently. Almost wherever you look in this motorway services, there's electric chargers scattered all over the place. So here we've got the two original Gridserve units, but as you can see, one of them currently is out of action. And then along here, we have got six Applegreen chargers, which are 175 kilowatt each. And every bay along here has a charging unit, and these have both Chademo and CCS on each. And in the middle here, there's additional eight Applegreen units, but these charge two vehicles at a time. So another 16 charging bays here in total, and these are all CCS2 only. So the price of these currently is 77 pence per kilowatt hour, and that's if you pay by contactless there, but by the looks of it, as it says on that signage there, if you use the Applegreen app, you get a 5 pence discount. And they've got all these rapid chargers here, which are quite clear to see. Yeah, all these vehicles here are combustion engine vehicles blocking the chargers. And that Porsche there was even sat with its engine running. The only vehicle, the one's just left there, the only vehicle that is charging is that Audi e-tron over there in the corner. And then over here in the corner are the original 12 Tesla supercharging bays. And these are version 2 superchargers, 150 kilowatt. And as you can see, it's very busy here as well. But look what's coming, an additional 24 version 3 superchargers. And these aren't far off from going live, because the chaps have been here on a Sunday working in the cabinets, but it looks like they're just packing up now. So if all these original ones stay, and I have my doubts whether those Gridserve ones will, but that means there are a total of 64 DC rapid charging bays at this one services. So it just goes to show when they get the new grid connections at these services, they're not just putting in one or two extra chargers, they're doubling, tripling or quadrupling the amount of units. And of course, when you've got a lot of chargers, there's also a lot of infrastructure. So along this edge now, there's a lot of cabinets, including these original ones down here and right down there. It will be interesting to see whether Tesla open these up to non-Tesla drivers as well, because you may well know Tesla's by far the cheapest network. These are typically 20 to 40 pence cheaper than the other networks. Their pricing does vary depending on time of day and how busy they are and whether you're a member or a Tesla driver. But either way, they're significantly cheaper than the rest. So I hope you found that useful. If you have, please do click the thumbs up button. That really does help. Also subscribe to the channel and ask any questions below. And if you want to know more about the UK public charging infrastructure, I'll put a link in the video description below to a playlist where you can see other videos I've made.